Okay, if you know Bank of Baroda, it's mostly by the western part of India where the Bank of Baroda started. Baroda is a place which is in Gujarat, and if you see the ethnically the Gujaratis who were also migrated to Kenya along with the railway line. Somewhere along the line there was a community of Gujaratis who had settled in here, and basically these people are business people. Okay, they developed business in India, they were thriving, and alongside they also were developing in Kenya. So somewhere along you have this feeling, you want to go back home, so they were coming to India. So somewhere that connection between Baroda and Indians, Asians settled in Kenya was there already. And Bank of Baroda being the bank in that area, it became a bank for those people coming from Africa to India. Automatically, because of business mindedness, other businesses developed. Like those days, remittances between the two countries, inward and outward remittances, and technical assistance in the form of you can do trade this way. Lot of things happened at that time. So Baroda was one of those banks growing that time, already knew about what is happening outside in Africa. So it was natural that when the bank was started growing in 1953-54, the bank also decided, now we need to go out of India. So the first thought came, why not Africa, where we already have our brothers and sisters settled and doing well. If you look at Bank of India and Bank of Baroda, both of them are from the western part of India at that particular point of time. And both had similar client base, and also they were in a way competitors with each other. They were of similar size, similar strategies and similar thinking and similar client base. So they were also the same people who came at that time. In those early days, it's very interesting. At that particular point of time, if you know Kenya, they had all the banks were mostly European and English. Okay, when Bank of Baroda and Bank of India came in, it was looked like an Asian banker, it's not possible, because business and banking was only for the Europeans. So that was a challenge. And once again, at that particular point of time, a bank had failed, a financial institution has failed, it was of Indian origin. So everybody, the perception was, they can't do, you can't rely on them. This was again a challenge. The bank had to face these two challenges and grow. At the time, the major competition was the European bank, but Bank of Baroda, with their ingenious strategy, they broke through the challenge. The strategy was very simple. These English banks were very formal and common people could not reach them. There were a lot of layers, they could not have gone and met the MD. But the Bank of Baroda, being an Asian banker, they were very open and approachable to every common person. So you and me could talk to each other and understand, and they provided the solution and the banking facilities. So this automatically made them people's bank at that particular point of time. Small businessmen, traders, everybody could come here. And also an innovative product those days, the savings account, wherein you can save a certain sum of money on a regular basis and get an interest, was innovated by this bank. So it became like very popular. Oh, I can also save my money. This was what was given at that time. So the bank could go through the competition successfully. We opened in Mombasa. Immediately within a year, we opened the Nairobi branch. But once these two branches were settling down, we realized there are pockets of business areas, like in Kisumu, like in Eldoret. But if you remember, in 1960s, the communication lines were very bad. Infrastructure was really not there. But how to serve those people in those places? Business was happening there. So Bank of Baroda found an innovative way, banking on wheels, which we today we call it a mobile banking, which in 1960 was a very rarity. It happened that time. They were commuting to that city and taking the bank, doing the banking service there and putting the money in Nairobi. This was, even for Bank of Baroda, this was the first experiment, banking on wheels in Kisumu. And from Kisumu and Kenya, it migrated to India, where it became the most popular service of today. So independence in every country opens a lot of doors. It's when you are independent, automatically it becomes the people's country, and even the government have to work for the betterment of the citizen of that country. At that point of time, everybody gets an opportunity, and when they take the opportunity, even the banking and financial institution has to cater to those opportunities arising. So when independence happened, automatically the Kenyans started developing, maybe slowly, from healthcare, education and everything. So the Asian Bank, Indian Bank, which already was here, decided to also become a subsidiary, that is, become Bank of Baroda Kenya Limited, and they started catering to all the local populace. Kenya and India is not very different in this gender differences, because in both the countries, family is the mainstay, and the responsibility of bringing up the family and culture is almost with the woman. This is the similar case in both the countries. Here in Kenya again, it is the same story. The woman had to take care of everything. At that particular point of time, if you know, woman cannot move too much away from the family. Woman cannot give long hours to be very competitive in her chosen career. She had to give equal time, a little more time, to the family. So at that particular point of time, Bank of Baroda, the institution, banking, and Baroda in particular, were doing a lot for the woman. See, the jobs available in bank is particular timing. It's maybe from 9 to 5 or 9 to 6. There is a definite timing. She is not required to work late hours. She can easily do her job, go home, take care of the children. So, and also the financial reward was quite good to take care of the family. This itself was a platform for the woman to come into banking jobs. And again, when the woman came into the banking job, she was encouraged to increase her educational qualification and skills. Once this was done, automatically she was encouraged to take higher positions. Though this was not done aggressively, in a subtle way, giving an economic freedom automatically brought them up. This you can see by the 34% woman representation in Bank of Baroda Kenya itself.